Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Travis with Team Hooked Up Fishing, and I'm getting ready to make a two-day trip up to Brewster, up by the Okanagan River to fish for some sockeye. I guess the bite's been like crazy mad up there. Watching some other videos, talking to some other people, the bite's just been off the hook. Catching limits in 30, 40 minutes, like 20, 30 fish at a time. So, basically, yeah, just getting ready to run out. I want to show you a quick rundown of what all I've got here. I've got my mini cuts. I've got some sockeye setups, some squids. Got my flashers. Got my 20 pound test. I got all kinds of little stuff here. I've got some homemade setups that I made, including this one here. A good little setup. Pink and so we're getting ready to head out here in a few days, and I'm gonna make a, like I said, a two-day trip. Run up Wednesday night, fish a little Wednesday night, probably fish all day Thursday, fish most of the day Friday, and then head back hopefully with a ton of fish. So anyways, hope you enjoy the video, and we'll catch you later. So we got rods at a different depth, so what's the deal? Yep. Oh, fish! There you go. Got him? What
it's on the, it's by the red.
The left one?
Okay. Good.
All right, we're on the board.
Rip its gills. It's the only difference.
Got him?
Yep.
Got him?
Yep.
Ooh, 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 ooh. Grab it.
Is that king?
That's that dodger working. Are you serious?
I'm dead there. I think so.
Oh, really? Really?
I can pop it.
Here, you want to see your whip?
Yeah. There in front of us. The fish just jumped right there in front. Look at them. Look at them. 1, 2, 3, 4 fish just jumped right there.
Got him. Yep, got him.
King or?
Oh, yeah, I'm pulling the rod too. Not a king, no.
There you go.
Yeah, look at that might be.
Whoa! That's a big one, dude. See, that's the only thing I don't like about this, because now it's harder to control it. Go.
Oh.
Did it come off? Did it break?
Oh, gosh, dang it. Oh, still there. Still there.
Got him?
Yep. Are you in here?
No.
Yep.
Thank you.
Oh, fish. Got it?
Yep. This one's going off too. Isn't it?
Can you cross into it? Small lure, dude. One more. Got him?
Yep.
No, man, take it.
Two limits, man.
Let's go.
Fishing anyways now. Two limits. We have to do it on this side. Alright.
You know what I'm saying? I got a boat.
put that green, the green beads.
Oh, fish right there, right now. You got him?
Are you serious?
I thought it was just bouncing from the, when you set it down.
Oh, reel that down to drop, would you?
Oh, is that a king? No, I'm serious. I thought it was just bouncing from the, but it kept bouncing. Ripping, dude. Do you have the N on there? Do you ever use the N?
What?
The N.
N?
You sure that's not a king? How are you going to weigh that fish? No way you're hooked up with someone. That's a fish.
No, I got a fish. I'm trying to steer the damn boat, too.
If there's an N on there, you should be able to hold it down, and it'll straighten and keep you that way, no matter what. If you hold it, you got to hold it down. I see it.
Get him, get him, get him! There you go.
It's gotta be
hatching, right?
Probably wild. Is it still fun?
That's a big fish, though.
Holy crap. Woo! There goes. That is an ugly wild fish, man.
Hello?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, dude. Love him, too. Not a sockeye, dude. Sure. No, I've hit a lot of it down it. Up here, yeah. Bonus. Good. I'm gonna drop it down the water. In there a little. Can't see that water.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Hey, I just wanted to give you guys a quick rundown. We got back from Brewster trip. Just wanted to give you a quick update on what was working well out there. I'll start off by telling you about my fishing poles that I was using. One of my rods that I was using was this Lamaglass 10-6 Certified Pro. Basically, this is my downrigging rod. And, you know, running that with a 40-pound Power Pro line, the Super Slick, the blue stuff, paired up with the Abu 5501C3 reel, the Ambassador. Great reel, great rod combo for doing the downrigger setup. The next setup I was using was this Wright & McGill Alaskan Heavy Drifter. Another great reel that I've caught a lot of salmon on. Same thing, 40-pound Power Pro blue line, super slick. And I had just picked this up from Bent Rod Tackle and Marine out there in Richland from Dave the other day. This brand new cold water Akuma with the line counter. This reel, amazing. I fell in love with it. It is top notch, great salmon fishing reel, even good for walleye too. Basically we were using that for running our dropper cannonballs on that. Basically I want to get a quick shot here real quick. We were using from Max lure out of Wenatchee. We were using these sockeye setups, these little squids with the different beads and stuff on them and the different smiley blades and whatnot. You can order these online at mack.com. I think it's mack.com or maxlure.com. You can Google it. But yeah, Max Lure, they've got top quality products. A lot of stuff that we were buying that we used from them was working really good. This was a really good one right here. This is a Max Smiley Blade 1.1 with the pink beads and the pink metallic Smiley Blade behind a Dodger. And the bigger Dodgers were actually working better. More stuff that we had tied up here. Some more of these pink and camo, but like I said, Max Lure, great products. And then we were just dropping a little bit of the the Northwest bait scent, the graybill salmon scent on there. Just give a little squirt of that on that shrimp on these double hook setups. So yeah. So anyways, yeah, like I said, basically just wanted to give you guys a quick rundown, things that were working really well for us. We were using between 4 and 6 ounce cannonballs on that dropper and trolling at a speed of about 0.8 to 1.1 miles an hour, just enough to get that quick jerk reaction back and forth. And also making sure that leader is really dead on between 12 and 14 inches is where it's really gotta be. That is a key on making those work right. So just use a little bit of Columbia bait shrimp on there, a little bit of dabs of the graybill salmon sauce and your Max lures that are already tied up, you know, and throw that on there with a Max double dodger, and you guys are set, you know, fishing anywhere between 15 to 25 feet on those line counters. So all right, if you got any questions, comment in the comment section, and also be sure to check me out on Instagram at fearnofish3, just fearnofish and the number 3 on Instagram, and we post a lot of pictures of fish that we've been catching and stuff like that, and be sure to check out Max Lure for their great products, and yeah, check out the video and let me know what you think.